Senator De La Rosa believes President Marcos is being pressured to cooperate with the ICC's probe into the drug war. Duterte's allies have repeatedly asserted the ICC has no jurisdiction to conduct the probe, citing the former president's withdrawal from the ICC. In November, Marcos said he was considering a possible return to the ICC's fold.
I have seen this a million times or a thousand times, sabi niya, or a million times, 100 times, that I'm not going to lift a finger in cooperating with the ICC. Mayroon lang mga tao nagpipressure sa kanya, siguro, nakikita ko, as I see it, na talagang gusto siyang ipa-cooperate sa ICC. So, kaya ganun na lang yung kanyang sitwasyon, no? Para lumalabas na laban bawi.
Meanwhile, self-confessed drug lord Kerwin Espinosa says he is willing to testify before the ICC. Duterte linked Espinosa and his father to the narcotics trade. The elder Espinosa turned himself in back in 2016 but was killed in detention. Human rights groups claim over 27,000 were killed during Duterte's bloody war on drugs. President Marcos welcomes visiting South Korean leader Yoon Suk-yeol to Malacañang as the two nations eye a strategic partnership. Katrina Domingo on the line now with details. Kat, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. The Philippines and South Korea have announced that they are working to elevate their relationship into a strategic partnership, with President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. noting that the move comes as the geopolitical environment is only becoming more complex. Now, in that bilateral meeting that happened inside Malacañang, President Marcos Jr. underscored that the Philippines and South Korea must work together to achieve prosperity for our peoples and to promote a rules-based order governed by international law, including the 1982 UNCLOS and the binding 2016 Arbitral Award, without directly mentioning China and its incursions in the West Philippine Sea. South Korean President Yoon Suk-yeol, on the other hand, underscored that the Philippines and South Korea have a special bond forged in blood, as the Southeast Asian country sent the largest contingent of troops to South Korea among Asian nations during the Korean War. Yoon underscores also that he is interested in elevating our relationship to a strategic partnership, which will bring our cooperation to a higher level. Let's listen to those statements.
During our fruitful bilateral meetings, President Yoon and I covered several areas of cooperation, including defense and security, maritime cooperation, economic and development cooperation, and people-to-people exchanges. We agreed that we have made significant strides in advancing and deepening our bilateral cooperation towards the attainment of our mutually beneficial goals.
Progress we've made so far in our bilateral relations was based on the trust and sense of solidarity forged in blood. Through my visit to Manila, I saw firsthand the ongoing dynamic development of this great nation under the leadership of President Marcos Jr. I also witnessed the infinite potential of Korea-Philippines relations. Today, President Marcos and I opened a new chapter of our partnership by elevating our relationship to a strategic partnership.
Now, to make that partnership more concrete, Carmina, the two countries signed 6 deals in Malacañang earlier today. Among those is a memorandum of understanding between the Philippine Coast Guard and the Korean Coast Guard. This cooperation in GIST basically strengthens the understanding and mutual trust between the two Coast Guards for them to be able to promote and preserve, as well as protect, their mutual maritime interests, including maritime order and safety in the Asia-Pacific region. Interestingly, the two countries also signed a memorandum of understanding on the feasibility study of the Bataan nuclear power plant, details of which we have yet to get later on today. Carmina, the 4 other deals include a deal on economic innovation partnership, a deal on the strategic cooperation on critical raw material supply chains, a loan agreement for several infrastructure projects, as well as the implementation program of the Memorandum of Understanding on Tourism and Culture. Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Katrina Domingo, there joining us on the line. The low-pressure area over the West Philippine Sea not expected to develop into a tropical cyclone. Let's get the latest on the weather from ABS-CBN's resident meteorologist Ariel Rojas. Ariel, over to you.
Hi, good afternoon, Carmina. Two weather disturbances are being monitored inside and outside the Philippine area of responsibility. And as you mentioned, the low pressure area over the West Philippine Sea is not expected to develop into a tropical cyclone and may dissipate either today or tomorrow, Tuesday. It was last spotted 145 kilometers west of Coron, Palawan, and will bring scattered rains throughout the day. Meanwhile, the tropical depression north of Guam was located more than 2,500 kilometers east of northern Luzon. It will not enter the PAR nor affect the country's weather as it will move towards east of Japan. The LPA is embedded along the Intertropical Convergence Zone or ITZZ, which along the easterlies bring moisture that form into thunderstorms. But the rains since this morning here in Luzon have been caused by the convergence of winds from the east and the northeast. Scattered rains will persist throughout through this afternoon over Metro Manila, Pangasinan, Nueva Vizcaya, Quirino, most of central Luzon, Rizal, Laguna, northern Quezon, and Camarines Norte. Mindoro, Bicol, and Panay can also expect thunderstorms later this afternoon and evening. That's the latest on the weather. This is Ariel Rojas. Back to you, Carmen.
Thanks a lot. Ariel Rojas there joining us live.